Gold exploration and development company Hummingbird Resources has told investors about the proposed acquisition of Gold Fields' Malian assets. Well, for more, I'm joined by Hummingbird's chief executive, Dan Betts. Now, Dan, so this deal transforms you from a single project into a multi-project company. What attracted you to these gold assets in particular?
Thanks very much for having me, Sarah. Well, there's a lot of answers to that question, really, because we see these assets as having a lot of natural fits with Hummingbird's project in Liberia, not least the fact that we believe we can get it into production very quickly and for a very small capital cost relative to the much bigger project we have in Liberia. So we see it as a catalyst to developing a pipeline of production for Hummingbird, and we see it as an amazing opportunity presented by this market, whereby gold fields and major companies are selling quality, high-grade assets that are too small for them in this gold price environment. And we have the opportunity to downscale the size of the asset and produce what is a very significant amount of gold for a company of our size, up to sort of 80,000 ounces a year in first year of production, and to make it happen very quickly. So an awful lot of things attracted us to this acquisition, and also buying it from a major. It gives you a certain level of comfort in the quality of work that's been done and the amount of data you're buying. I mean, to put that in context, we're buying a database of over 500 kilometers of drilling, and it's had over $100 million spent on this project. Comes with a $65 million tax write-off against future profits, which will be hugely valuable to us. And I think having Gold Fields as a major shareholder and their support in Hummingbird by taking stock for this asset is a ringing endorsement that should give shareholders a lot of comfort.
Now, Dan, why is Gold Fields actually selling the project?
Well, major companies have a need for a much greater scale of project to meet their internal thresholds. And really, unless they can see a resource producing 250 or 300,000 ounces a year and having a 3 million ounce resource, it really doesn't meet their internal criteria. But of course, that's an enormous project, and the resource at Yanfolila is 1.8 million ounces at 2.8 grams a ton. But what we want to do is actually just focus on the oxide material, which is something a major would never do. To just have perhaps a million ton a year processing plant producing 80,000 ounces a year, it's simply not big enough for them. But it's very big for us and very significant for us. And I think the fact, as I say, that they've sold this asset to us for stock. Shows that they believe it's highly profitable and a very robust and economic project, and they want to be exposed to that development and that unlocking of value. But it's just not worth their time to put the juggernaut of Gold Fields behind developing it. So it's a perfect deal for them as well. They get to see it expedited and developed quickly by us, and they retain exposure to the upside. So whilst they're selling it, they're still geared into the upside. And obviously it presents an amazing opportunity for us.
You're talking about the juggernaut. What is still left to do before you reach production?
So Gold Fields prepared this project to the point where they were ready to make a construction decision. But they did it on a bigger plant for a bigger mine. So what we will need to do immediately, and we've already started over the due diligence period, is to rescale the engineering work that's been done to a smaller plant to process just the oxides. But because that work's been done to a level of completion where Gold Fields were ready to start, it's really very very short piece of work. All the drilling's been done, all the permitting's been done, the project comes with a 30-year mine life, environmental issues have been resolved, geotech and hydrological issues have been resolved. So they're really... There's no question marks, technically or politically, about this project working. It's just a question of re-engineering the scale as quickly as possible to a plant that we can afford and we can deliver quickly.
And are those some of the reasons why you chose to buy this instead of a project that was at an earlier stage within its development?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, I think with Hummingbird, we've got a lot of gold in our Liberian projects, and there's no doubt that the Liberian projects at Dubi are, you know, a company maker for us, and there's a huge amount of gold there, but it's a big project. And to get another project that is earlier stage doesn't make much sense. We need to get one that is later stage, like this Yanfolila project, where we can see early cash flow and early production, and of course blue sky. And like Hummingbird in Liberia, this Yanfolila package of assets is it's a belt scale regional play. So we've now got 5,000 square kilometres of highly prospective exploration as well, and 6 million ounces of gold. So I think it turns us overnight almost into a relatively significant player in the space. You know, you've got de-risked gold, near production, higher grade, and you've got a clear pipeline to production.
So you have people interested in funding this project. We read that in the release. Can you tell us a bit more about that, who these people are and why they're interested in funding it?
Well, I can't tell you who they are because we haven't finalised anything yet, but I can tell you that we're in final discussions with a number of parties that are all keen to fund the development of this project. And the reason is it's of a scale that meets many investment firms' mandate, and obviously the returns are exceptional. I mean, with an IRR of around 54% in this gold price environment, and at $1,000 gold, still at sort of 34% IRR, you've got an excellent return on your investment and excellent security that you get paid back. So the logic for wanting to invest in it is fairly apparent. I mean, I've said for a long time now that Hummingbird is adamant that it wants to protect shareholder value and build shareholder value, and will only use the equity markets when the equity markets are working. And unfortunately, they haven't been working for a long time now in terms of accessing capital at a fair value for both sides of the equation. So we will continue to look for alternative sources of financing that other than straight equity and straight placements until such a time as we see the equation being more equitable and there being fair value for both sides, both the company and the investors.
In terms of sort of both sides, Gold Fields will become your largest shareholder with a 26% stake. How will it help the company advance the assets?
Well, Gold Fields, I mean, have agreed to provide management services to help us with the transition period. As much as anything, that's with relationships and in country. But, I mean, the responsibility for developing it will be driven by Hummingbird. That said, the key members of the Goldfields technical team, the project engineers and managers that were involved in the Yanfolila project, are moving across. So Goldfields per se will not be helping in the development of this project, but the skills that were in Goldfields will be assumed into Hummingbird as part of this deal. So inadvertently, a huge amount of help, if you follow what I'm saying.
Now, briefly, Dan, how confident are you of keeping to your strict timeline to production, which is planned at the end of 2015?
I'm confident. I think that because of the level of work that's been done by Goldfields, admittedly for a different size plant, but I think, you know, the things that can derail you and take a long time, such as resource re-estimation and stuff, has been done. So I think it's an aggressive, but it's a realistic timeline, and I'm confident.
Well, finally, will you need to make any more acquisitions to achieve your goal of becoming a mid-tier producer, or is it a case of just bringing these mines online?
Oh, Sarah, look, we've got our hands full. I mean, I think when you say do we need to, the answer is absolutely not. No, we've got our hands full, we've got lots of gold, we've got clearly defined projects that we can bring into production, and we've got great shareholders to support us doing that. That said, as I said before this deal, I think this market is a unique, once-in-a-generation opportunity to acquire undervalued and distressed assets, and if opportunity comes knocking, you've got to be ready to take it. That's how you become successful and build a gold company, I believe. So, no, of course we're not looking, but you never know.
Dan Betts, Chief Executive of Hummingbird, thank you very much for your time indeed.
Thanks, Sarah.